Hey y'all, welcome to another WordPress Wednesday. My name is Corey Ashton and we're talking today about blogs. And for the entire month of March, that's what I want to talk to you about. Best practices with your blog, how to set categories and tags, and how to create custom menus for your blog. We're gonna have all sorts of fun this month, so be sure to subscribe to our channel. Every WordPress Wednesday, you'll get a great video like this coming in your inbox to tell you more about how to improve your WordPress website. So today's topic is all about categories versus tags. And if you're searching for this topic and you're a little confused, don't feel bad because apparently there are a lot of people out there that are confused. And I've gone even today to prepare for this video looking for different resources to figure out how others are explaining it. And to be honest with you, I know what categories and tags are and I got confused reading their blog articles. So let me see if I can just simplify it for you today, help you clearly get a vision of how to use categories and tags on your WordPress website, all right? I'm gonna use WP Tavern as our example blog because these guys over here are doing it right. And if you're not familiar with them, take a second to check them out. They're all things WordPress. They'll talk about the news with Automatic. They'll talk about plugins and reviews. They'll talk about security risks and different things going on there. So be sure to subscribe to their blog. That's a shout out to these guys, way to go. But I am right now on their category called news. So if you open up their categories drop down here, you can see all the different categories that they have written articles for or posts for and put them inside, assign them to these categories. I'm going to scroll down here and click on one for Stripe. And Stripe is a payment gateway that you can use for your WordPress website if you want to be selling things. So it's like a PayPal or an authorized.net. That's what Stripe is. When I click on the name, we go into the actual individual blog post, right? And you see this is the author, Sarah, and this is the date that she published this on. And as we scroll down, we're able to read the article. We get to see a really cool box here for an author box. She's got some share icons, but this is what I'm looking for right here. The fact that this article was posted in e-commerce and news. These are two different categories. You can see as I hover over them, they underline two totally different categories. And then she's also using the tags of Automatic, Stripe, and WooCommerce. So we see what she's doing, but what the heck is the difference, right? Here's what I want you to envision. When you see this little folder icon, that in my brain is what a category is. It's like a folder. Categories are your main topics that your entire website will be writing about or having resources for, okay? So this particular blog website has articles on WordPress specifically about e-commerce topics and news topics. Then they're utilizing tags to mention kind of these are like keywords inside of this one article that maybe if you're interested specifically in Stripe, you can click on that and see any other blog posts that might have had the topic or the tag of Stripe inside of it, okay? So let's see if they have anything else. Yeah, they have a couple of other, they have two articles here that happen to mention Stripe inside of them. So while Stripe itself is not a major topic that they're talking about, like their categories, it's still a topic that people might be interested in, and it's like a keyword inside of this one particular article. So here's the way I want to break it down. Post. A post is one blog article, right? That's what WordPress calls a blog article. It's a post. Posts need to be categorized. They need to be organized. So you put those in categories. And a category is like a main topic. So that's basically what I want you to think a category is. A category is a main topic, and you can think of these like folders. Okay? That makes it kind of simple, right? Tags, we want to think of tags as keywords, and I'm probably going to get some backlash on this. I'm sure people are going to be like, that's not the way I've heard it explained. In my brain, this is the way it works, and tell me or not if this works for you. You can put some comments down in the comment box below, but check this out. Categories is your main topic. So they have topics like news and plugins and themes and BuddyPress. Those are the main topics that they're going to be writing a bunch of articles for that they want to categorize and put into these folders, right? These categories. Then these same articles that you're writing about might mention other topics. They might be talking about specific things that you want to highlight as well, but they aren't major topics like categories. So WordPress gives you an option called tags. And in my brain, it works well to call these keywords. All right. I'll give you one more quick example, and then I'll call it a day. On WebTegrity's website, we have our tutorials. When you click that link up here for tutorials, you're going to see running down the right side of our blog over here all these different topics. These are the categories of all the articles we've written. We have over 200 different articles that we've written, and they all get assigned to one of these major topics. So if you're looking for WordPress Wednesday stuff, you would click this topic, and every article that we've ever written and assigned to that category would then display down this page dynamically and let you look through all the different topics having to do with WordPress Wednesday. But if you're just interested in maybe something like, let's say, social media marketing, you can click on social media marketing and then get all the articles in that category displayed to you, so you can read and see different resources that are all about social media. I hope this helps you a little bit. If you have more questions, if I haven't completely cleared this up for you, put them in the comment box below, send me a tweet, reach out to me. I'd love to help explain this even further and help you out. Next week, we're going to talk about how to make custom menus for your categories inside your blog. I'll see you then. Hope you're having a great one. Bye, y'all.